Hi everyone, I'm Charlene Habermeyer of Good Parenting Brighter Children, and this is Tidbits of Wisdom for Parents. Today we're going to talk about how to introduce science, different types of science topics and subjects to your kids so that they'll love them, so it'll pique their interest. Now, you know I'm a big advocate of the arts, and I'm a big advocate of parents reading to their children. I think one way of doing it is through books, and then taking what you read in books and actually doing something physical. And certainly there's tons of different science museums around for kids nowadays, and take advantage of those. Take your kids to all of them. But again, like I've mentioned with everything, always prepare your child before taking them, and then take them back oftentimes so that they fall in love. So what do we do when we first start out teaching our kids about science and science experiments and things? Well, we read to them. So, how much is a million? Now, this book is kind of mucked up. My kids loved it. But how much is a million? You can go through and it tells you all different things and it makes compare contrast into how much is an actual million and even a trillion and beyond that. One of my very favorite books is Snowflake Bentley. This is an interesting story about a man who was the first man to actually photograph snowflakes and all the gyrations and everything that he had to go through to actually get some amazing photographs of snowflakes. His photographs that he photographed of snowflakes are still used today, and it talks about how even as a young boy, he loved the cold weather. And the reason he loved the cold weather is because he loved the snow and he loved the snowflakes. And he goes in and he talks about the various shapes of snowflakes and the configuration of snowflakes. Even though this seems like a simple scientific topic, if you're putting it in the topic of a story and they're reading a story with different interesting facts on the sidelines on each page, it will help them to fall in love with science. Another book is Turn, 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 and this is from Ecclesiastics, and this is the whole thing about seasons. And the song, of course, that was written in conjunction with this. So this goes through every season of the year, and it has gorgeous and beautiful illustrations. It will help you to introduce to your children about the seasons. What happens with the seasons? What happens with the cold weather? What happens with the warmer weather? What happens with the hot weather? How does the whole landscape change? How do birds and animals and plants and shrubs and trees and all of those things change with every season of the year? Is particularly powerful if you're living in an area of the country that actually has four seasons, because you can teach your children that there is beauty in every season of the year and that there is something to enjoy of every season of the year. As we see in all the different sports, there's winter sports, there's spring sports, summer sports, there are all different kinds of sports that you can enjoy during every season of the year. This is a National Geographic series. This one is on how animals talk. Have you ever thought about how animals actually converse with each other, how they talk to each other, how they talk back and forth to each other? This other book that I told you earlier in another tidbit, The Rubber Band Banjos and a Java Jive Bass, this one also goes into how animals talk to each other because it goes into vibrations and sounds and tones. So you can actually talk about the science behind how animals talk. And of course, if you want to go into the whole science behind music and musical instruments, this is the perfect one to sit down with your child and actually make musical instruments. Now, I don't think that there's a child alive or a family alive that ever goes through their entire existence in their childhood without ordering an ant farm or an ant kit. There are numbers of different books out there that you can get about ant cities, and ants are the most industrious insect out there. Of course, bees are equally as industrious, and it shows how all of these ants work together as a team. They're the worker ants, like the worker bees. They all work together as a team. It's fun for kids to see because when you buy an ant farm and you get all these ants, they're usually larger ants. You put them in these colonies and you're able to see how they're all working together, how they're making their homes and building these things. It's always fun and interesting. When kids are particularly young, introduce them to dinosaurs. If there's a dinosaur museum in your city or state or community, by all means take them to see the dinosaurs. There's a number of different songs now about dinosaurs that are out there. I know that they were around when my kids were little, and as a family, we sang those songs. We went to the dinosaur museums. We had all kinds of dinosaur books. We drew dinosaurs. We had dinosaur t-shirts. Kids are enthralled with dinosaurs, and you can see why. They're very interesting looking creatures. As they get older, here's a great one. I love Tommy DiPaolo. This is a book about popcorn. It talks about the history of popcorn. It talks about all the different kinds of popcorn. And there's tons and tons and tons of recipes for popcorn. So you can actually talk about popcorn, how it got started, how it's made, you know, popping popcorn as opposed to the popcorn, or as opposed to the corn you eat off the cob, and the whole history behind it. And then you can make up a recipe, and there's recipes included in here as well. You can, and all of these activities that you do, you want to bring in the science activities so that they realize that they're learning about a subject that is fascinating and interesting. This is another series. This is the Magic School Bus series. These have been out for, I'm sure, over 20 years now. And this woman takes them on this magic school bus, and they go in and they study all these different aspects of science. On this one, they're studying inside the earth, and on this one, they're studying about water. Now, sharks, anything that has to do with something that's mean of the deep, and of course, Jaws put sharks on the map. So there's all different kinds of books out there that talk about different kinds of fish, and predator fish, and regular fish, and going fishing, and you can take them to an aquarium, and you can see all of the different types of fish up close and personal, including different types of sharks. Now, during the summer, it's really fun to get a telescope. It doesn't have to be a super expensive one, or you can even take them to like an observatory where they have these incredible telescopes, and they can look up at the sky, and they can see all of the fabulous stars there are up in the heavens and the sky. They can see all of the different configuration of the stars and how the stars are named and in different galaxies. Another fun thing that you can do for one of your kids for their birthday or Christmas present or something in their stocking is that you can actually have a star named after them. You can go online, there's different websites, and it's pretty inexpensive. For like $12 or $15, you can have a star named after one of your children, or all of your children have each one named for each child. They will send you all of the information about that star, about that galaxy, and they'll send you big printouts of the entire thing. And so you can talk about stars and what they're made of and how many they are and about the Milky Way and so on. There's all of these other types of books. These are about creepy crawlers. These are about different aspects of science, of things that you may or may not know. And of course, the Berenstain Bears has one out that's all about the science fair. I don't know how many of you, your kids are involved in science fairs. A lot of schools they don't have science fairs anymore. I think part of the problem is that they give the assignment to the parent or to the child. The child's overwhelmed, so it goes to the parent. And if the parent doesn't feel comfortable about science, then it becomes this overwhelming, very difficult project for the child. I know when I was growing up, we always had science fairs. There was one year that my father helped me, but the rest of the time he didn't. And my mother didn't help me, and I was overwhelmed on what I should do. But I do remember the time that I remember very distinctly the science project that we put together. It was about conductivity of electricity in liquids. And I had these two battery electrode things, and you know, according to a salt solution, a soda, a solution with baking soda, it would light up a light bulb. And I became fascinated with science just from simple science projects. So when our kids got into school and into middle school, they were required to do science projects. My husband and I, we jumped on the bandwagon of this because we both enjoy science and we both like science and we wanted to be involved. Another thing is there are tons and tons of calendars out there. So at the end of January or February, when all of them go on for like 80% off, and of course, being a school teacher, I'm always looking for things like this that you can use in the classroom. And you know, with my kids, I pretty much wanted them to be my classroom for a lot of years. So go and you can get amazing calendars on different aspects of science, from insects to all different things. Now, if you've kept science alive in your home and you've made it a part of the learning that you do with your kids, when they get to be teenagers or a little bit older, introduce them to other books that have to do with science. And let me share with you my top three. This one is The Hidden Life of Trees. It was on the New York Times bestseller. It's about a forester actually in Germany, and he talks all about trees. And he talks about how trees communicate. We talk about animals communicating with each other. Well, trees actually communicate with each other too. And like animals don't all get along and people don't all get along, well, trees don't all get along either. There are some trees that just flat out don't like each other. But there also are trees that do like each other, and they help each other, and they protect each other in different ways. This is a fabulous book, and if you read it as a parent, then as you're reading it, you can share different aspects of it so that they come to have an understanding of the of love of nature. This one is The Genius of Birds, and I happen to love birds. In my next life, I think I'll be a bird watcher. But this talks about how incredibly smart birds are, how they communicate with each other, how they actually build tools, how they hide those tools, how they can come back, you know, after a season of winter, and they can actually dig up those tools that they have made the previous year. So it talks about how they communicate and how just how birds are so incredibly smart. That's a fascinating book. Now, if you have a child who loves to be in the kitchen, this one, Kitchen Science, is a great one. I love this one because if you read it as a parent, as you're in the kitchen with your kids, you can explain different things of what's going on. How does yeast work? How does baking soda and baking powder work? Why do we put salt into things? What does that create? If we combine certain types of things, what will it do? What causes something to rise? What causes something to stay flat? There are tons of things, and it's all contained in this Kitchen Science book, including if you boil an egg and you boil it incorrectly, why you get the green around the yolk when you break it open, a hard-boiled egg, and you have that green film around the yolk. I mean, it's perfectly safe, but here it gives you an opportunity to explain to your children exactly what's going on. If you want to introduce your children to science, make it fun. Again, go to those fun museums, prepare them before you go, get all kinds of different books from the library, and intermix them with the other books on other literature topics that you're reading to them. Just intermix those different science topics, and as they ask you questions, be there to answer them. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow.